What is going on there? I don't think that's a New Year celebration. What the heck? It's raining so much, there's actually geese here now. How fitting that it's raining today again, huh? It's just been such a wet month this year. What is going on? I guess the cancellation of the fireworks for New Year's Eve is, I guess, good timing from their point of view anyways. The last day of the year, it just went by so fast for me personally. Just with all, I guess, the challenges and stuff like that. I was debating what I should do, like just creatively, like for the video and stuff like that. I ended up creating a drone video and as well, I guess, like a summary video, kind of like what I did last year. Except this year, there was like so many trials and tribulations. It actually turned out a little too sad, I think, in the beginning, but you try to be positive with what you have afterwards, because one of the key highlights for me is just with everyone's support and stuff like that, helping me replace the broken camera and all that. As I was making it, I was one of those, I want to do like a little more here. I need to do this to make it a little bit more, I guess, impactful to express what I'm trying to express. But it's just a matter of time too, just with things like hardware and stuff, because the video itself, like imagine every time you have to export it, like render it, it'll take about maybe 2 hours or so because it's in 4K, and then you'll have to upload it. So you really don't have time to really play around with it, sit there and determine, okay, what can I change here? So I kind of just went with it for the most part. I guess for today, for sure, no flying the drone too, huh? Just like I said before, it's not regulations that are the biggest obstacles many times, it's the weather. Whether or not we'll get some good drones in 2020, I think probably so. Lots of new announcements and stuff, as you guys know. And with the CES really close by, we'll probably see a lot of great new stuff, not just drones either. Kind of makes me think, what should I say and do for this last video entry for the year? I know for the other video, I expressed it more in an artistic way, I guess you could say. I guess this will be more of a down-to-earth way, just like I did, I guess, last year. And holy cow, it sounds like the rain just kicked it up a notch or so. But I guess in terms of, like I said in the other video, my summary, it's basically the year of the gear failure. Holy cow, every single thing failing, huh? The camera, the drone, even the phone with the battery and all that, man. Like, I know I use my stuff for a long time before I even intend to replace it all, just due to things like budget and financial reasons and all that, but still, all at the same time, that's crazy. But the craziest thing for me personally is just seeing how many people actually came out to support me afterwards, whether it's just through positive words or, for example, telling me why whatever it is that I make makes it better for you, like in your life. And then at the same time, people are actually donating their hard-earned money to help me get like a replacement and all that. I mean, that is crazy, and I thank everyone again for all your support, because generally speaking, people don't normally do that. I mean, I guess you guys are the anomaly, or you're really unique, because the majority of the people just saying wouldn't care. For me personally, that's actually really rare. That's why I'm really grateful for it. I mean, I know one person actually said to me, he's like, wow, like I'm surprised on how thankful you were, like with all the people that were helping you. That's because in many cases, people wouldn't care in those situations. I guess my best analogy would be just imagine like someone playing music or something like that on the streets. Most people just walk by, correct? Like even if they enjoy the music or whatever, they're just like, okay, goodbye. They wouldn't actually do anything. So that's why I said, you appreciate everything that people give you. The funny example for that actually is during the time when I was making those videos with the bad bulky camera and all that, telling how you guys are helping me get a new one, you still had like a person make like some kind of comment saying, man, I find your information really interesting, informative or whatever, but they can't stand like the camera, like get a new camera. To me it's like, do you not understand the context of the video? This person lost his equipment and basically there's no funding for him to do so. Like that's my example. The majority of people would be like that. Like I don't care what happens to the actual person. I just want what I want. So again, thank you very much for everyone who's offered your help and support. And it was really nice to actually get that support in various different ways too. I mean, it just could be from people's time, or like I said, they actually donated money. It's actually great because hearing that the things that you create, for example, actually brings, like, say, a smile to someone's face at the end of the day. I mean, what more could you ask for? I guess the biggest challenge was basically getting the drone license and all that, and we were able to do that, so that's actually really great. And I guess with next year having the option with a smaller drone, like with the Mini, I basically have the potential to film a lot more different stuff. I guess an interesting thing too during the process was you could kind of clearly see the types of people who were clearly in it just for themselves to make the money off, like, all these regulations, ridiculous test process and all that. And those that basically just want to enjoy it and encourage others to use it. Even with schools, for example, like Evan, I said, I don't care if people want to make money and or living, like teaching people and all that. But at the same time, for those people who say, like, man, everything needs to be even more strict, people need to be charged more money and so forth, like, that's just ludicrous in my opinion. And the funny thing is, just from my personal experience, even from doing the videos and so forth, it seems like most of the people that try to, like, attack me, so to speak, if you want to say, they claim to be Canadian flight reviewers, that's what they say, but it seems like most of the times when you talk about the facts and stuff, they can't actually talk about it. They only attack me, like, personally in a prejudiced and discriminating way. Seriously, makes me wonder if I should have made a video like that. Transport Canada promotes discriminating and prejudiced flight reviewers. Is that a headline grabber? But with that in mind too, I'm really thankful that I was able to find people who genuinely were trying to encourage people to use the tech in a responsible way and all that, and they recognize, for example, the way things are, they just don't make sense for a lot of people. So I'm really thankful for everyone who I've met who basically have the positive and more rational approach into trying to encourage things like those regulations so more people can enjoy it, again, in a responsible way that's not over the top, that actually stops and discourages people from using it. Because even for a person like me, I use it to capture video and stuff, which I would assume, for the most part, there's no harm in it. You use it responsibly, and it makes people happy, and it could be really educational as well. With that thought too, just about meeting the right people and essentially having them support me in various ways, I hope whatever it is I'm doing is actually continuing to bring that positivity in your life, whatever it may be, because I don't 100% know what it is for most people. For example, I even mentioned, like, in my other video, it could be you just like seeing animals or something like that. I don't know, like squirrels and all that. I know some of you guys might like the fact that I'm kind of updating you on what's happening and all that stuff. And that kind of dives into the other point, which I'm really grateful for, because many times, just from my observation from other people and all that, when you see a group of people support one person, it kind of puts them, like, in a little box saying, okay, now that I've given you this, you must do this now. Like, otherwise you're, like, whatever. You're betraying them and all that. Whereas for the most part, for you guys, it seems like you supported me and you're giving me, like, say, the resources and all that because you trust me, like, in life in general to do the right thing, so to speak. And for that, I'm thankful for, because I just know there's so many people, like, even for this, even if they do it for fun or they do it whatever, if they actually do it for their jobs, they just get into this cycle where they do stuff that they really hate just because, you know, there's a lot of people they feel if they don't do that, then they're letting them down. Whereas in this case, I still feel that I can create and express what I want and not be afraid that I'm going to be, like, attacked by a mob of 1,000 people or something like that. So thank you guys for that too. I mean, it takes a really mature audience, so to speak, to do that. It makes me wonder, what could I do differently as well? Because in some ways too, creatively, I'm saying to myself, like, in my mind, I need to try something more challenging as well because I'm getting a little too comfortable. Because I know a lot of people say, oh my god, you put, like, a videos up every single day. It's like a full-time job, honestly. Just with the way I set everything up, it is part-time. The only difference is most people would do something like, I don't know what it would be, watching TV or something like that for, like, an hour or two. Instead, I just edit the video. So it's just a different lifestyle choice and all that. Some of you guys even gave me suggestions and stuff like that. I remember one specific comment, one of you said, you know, I'm passionate about drones and stuff like that, but maybe I should now start trying to capture epic animal footages. And it made me ask the question where there was no clarification. What do you mean by epic animal footage? Because in general, everything I capture from the drone and stuff like that, honestly, it's on a whim. I don't really plan for it or anything like that. It's just, okay, sunny day, whatever, let's capture it here. Same thing with the animals and the squirrels. So when it comes to epic, I'm guessing people mean things like quality and stuff, like high-res cameras, which that unfortunately comes down to situations like hardware and resources and stuff, which obviously means money. And when you're doing it for a hobby and stuff like that, obviously it's not really feasible in that sense, if that's what you guys mean in that case. But yeah, I'm just trying to think of ideas how to do things a little differently in terms of making things better too. And some of those wacky stuff of the year, I guess one of the biggest ones was that guy stealing my drone video and me finding out that he basically promoted himself in the media as in like, hey, I'm the guy that captured this and all that. Crazy geese lady, I posted all that like in the other video. But we got through the year overall. I actually didn't even get my thermal camera back. I did actually email them. They said, yeah, they basically checked it out and everything, so I won't be expecting it back until next year. And it is the new decade too. I know there's some things happening here in Vancouver, like there's an anniversary for the 2010 Olympics and all that. So who knows what the future will hold, because I can't predict what's going to happen. I didn't predict a lot of the stuff that would happen, did happen, like this year at least. Okay, this is turning into a really long talk. I thought it was just going to be something really simple. What should I do today in terms of, I guess, to end everything off? Since it's raining and all that, I guess I'll do the usual as well too. Have some drone footage at the end just from the archive. Maybe some of the stuff that I didn't really get to use like for my end one. And maybe include some of the animal stuff too. Maybe I should try to mesh it in because again, there was a lot I didn't actually use just because of the way the video was flowing and all that. And yeah, I did walk literally over 7,000 kilometers. It wasn't actually too bad or anything. That's just the way it is when you walk for most of your transportation and stuff. But as always, if there's anything you ever do want to see, I mean, let me know. Because many times, there are things that I have that a lot of people don't have. For example, like even for camping stuff, I'm still surprised there's actually no squirrels, like you guys were telling me, in certain places. I thought they would be as common as like a pigeon, honestly. I mean, if it brings people happiness and joy and stuff like that, I don't mind doing it, as long as I have the means and so forth. I guess it's going to be a common joke you're going to hear today. See you guys next year! Alright, see you guys later.